Higgins.
Mrs. Reynolds, nice to see you again.
I wish I could say the same. Sit down if you like.
Thank you.
Well, you've certainly run up quite a few charges, including jumping bail and running off to Sydney.
Just catching up on some old friends.
Judging from this, those so-called friends were former prisoners who'd received unusually early releases, signed by you. Frankly, I find it difficult to understand that you, of all people, could have become involved in these schemes. Apparently, you haven't denied any of it.
Why should I? The truth is, I was bored. All those hard luck stories and innocent faces. Unbearable. So I decided to try a little trading, push the system a bit. A few things the prisoners wanted in exchange for a few favors I could use. Let's face it, what prisoner doesn't want a shorter sentence?
And you obviously never stopped to think of the effect that this would have on the people running those prisons.
What difference does it make? Nothing ever changes. It's them and us.
I shouldn't have to remind you that you are now one of them.
Technically. It's not quite the same, is it? We're professionals. We understand each other.
I disagree. As long as you're in here, you'll be treated the same as everyone else. However, it'd be foolish to pretend that there won't be some women who may not take kindly to your presence. For the moment, you'll be kept in the isolation block.
Very thoughtful.
Mrs. Morris, would you take Sarah Higgins to her cell, please?
By the way, I hope you haven't forgotten that little favor I did for you.
Favor?
Mitchell, Mrs. Reynolds, remember? You asked me to be lenient on her. I kept my side of the bargain. I hope you're going to keep yours.
Let's go.
So, this is home. Looks worse this side of the fence.
You'll get used to it. You probably know this inside out. But now you're going to have to live by it. A duty officer will bring your meals, and another officer will be in the vicinity all the time, in case you need help.
You honestly think one officer's going to be enough if any of that rabble come looking for me?
Perhaps this rabble isn't quite the mob you take it for.
Come off it, Mrs. Morris. They're a rat pack. They breed in places like this.
Just you keep your ideas to yourself.
And pretend it isn't true? Let me tell you. If civilization ever pulled its head out of the sand, it'd see the obvious solution. Sterilization. Stop them passing it down the line.
Is that so? Well, for your information, I was bred in a place like this. Yes. Yes, my mother happened to be one of those women you'd like to see sterilized. But judging by present company, I consider myself damn lucky I had the upbringing I did.
I wasn't actually referring to you, Mrs. Morris.
I don't care who you were referring to. Just make your bed. I'll be back in half an hour to check.
Please, Mrs. Reynolds, I'm not overreacting. I just don't know how much longer I can take it in isolation.
It's for your own protection.
You can't go on protecting me forever. And there's no doubt in my mind I'll be convicted. So it may as well be sooner than later.
Believe me, I can understand you're wanting to be moved, but... Look, let me think about it. I'll check with the department and let you know.
Thank you.
Got a new inmate for you, ladies. Meet Sarah Higgins. I'll leave you to make her feel welcome.
This is going to be awkward for all of us, but I hope we can work it out. I would like some food.
Go jump.
I would like some food, now.
What's the trouble?
No trouble. Just a slight misunderstanding, that's all.
Hi. Remember me?
No, I didn't think so.
Well, I remember you. Higgins, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Kelly. Louise Kelly. Name ring a bell?
No.
I was hauled in front of you three times.
I'm sorry. I don't remember all the names and faces.
We all looked the same to you, did we? Nothing but file numbers that kept you away from your game of golf or your afternoon tea parties. And all the time you were selling your favours to those rich bitches who could afford it. That's why you don't remember me. Because I was one of the poor bastards you never gave a second thought to.
Now, you turn around and walk out of here, or I'll rearrange your face.
So, the Toorak tart's no cream puff. There are dozens of ways to fix you, Higgins. And I know them all.
Memory's a bit hazy tonight. Correct me if I'm wrong. If I'm the judge, and I am, the jury is here. Defence counsel here. Prosecution here. Correct? Correct. Thought so. Okay, Jude.
All very theatrical, ladies, but I'm not interested. Good night.
It's not up to you, Higgins. The women think you owe them a trial, and I agree with them.
And I have no say in it, I suppose.
Oh, you'll get your say. You even have a defence counsel.
Yeah, which is more than you gave us.
Prosecution, Rebecca Keane. Jury and jury foreman. Sorry, person. Judy Bryant. Defence counsel, Pixie Mason.
Do you really expect me to believe that I'll get a fair trial?
If ours had been as fair.
You been counting, Bobby? How many times have you faced Miss Higgins?
About 3 times, I reckon.
Out of those 3 times, how often do you get a fair hearing?
Just the last time. I copped extra time on the others and I still haven't figured out about the last one yet.
Know something, Bobby? Neither have I. What did you bribe her with?
Nothing! I never stuck up
to... She didn't give me the time of day. Just sentenced me to an extra 6 months.
Without asking if you were guilty or innocent of the charges?
She didn't even look at me. She just read out the charge and handed down the sentence.
No further questions.
She said I was guilty and that was that. Same as always, cos we're here, we're guilty. She treated us like scum.
All right, Lou, stick to the facts.
Facts? God, the room's full of them. And what about the ones who aren't here? Farrah, for instance. Poor old Biddy copped an extra 6 months for something she didn't even do. Same as Lizzie. This bitch tried to stop her parole.
I was the visiting judge. I had to make instant decisions.
You mean you were only acting out what the department expected of you?
Yes. That's the same as you being top dog, Myra. You have to be strong to be respected.
Were you worried about losing your job if you were too lenient?
Yes. Look, none of you understand. I didn't enjoy handing out punishments. I only had a charge sheet and the officer's reports. I didn't know any of you then or any of your problems. You were just files with criminal record.
The jury has made a decision. The verdict is guilty.
Do you have anything to say before I hand down a sentence?
Not much point, is there? But remember, if anything happens to me, you'll all get extra time.
Sarah Higgins, I hereby sentence you to cleaning the cells of all those that you've sentenced. To losing your buy-up to anyone who loses theirs. To doing punishment duties for anyone who receives it. All that is to apply for 6 months. So you'd better pray they send you to another prison when you go to trial.
Night, Higgins. See you in the morning.
What the hell was that? Lucky Mason!
Oh, God, what's the matter?
Sarah, she's dead! Somebody's killed her!